That you are a finisher. You are a finisher. This day you have proven to your parents, your future employer, your future loan officer or account manager, your future college advisor, the world, and most importantly, yourself, that you have the ability to finish. And for this fact, you ought to give yourselves another round of applause. Come on, applaud yourself on finishing. In the last year, and I thank God for his peace and strength and comfort, in the last year, I laid to rest both of my parents, my mother about 9 months ago, my father about 6 or 7 weeks ago. There was something that my mother, I had a long debate with her where I was trying to talk my way out of going to college. I said, I'm gifted. I'm a musician. I'm going to make music and travel the world. And mommy said, not today. And I said, but why do I have to waste time going on to further education? She said, you won't be wasting time. I said, I don't even know what I want to study. She said, I don't care. Find something, and you are going to not only study it, you're going to finish it. And I said, why? She said, it is important for you to prove to yourself and to others that you have the ability to take on a task and finish. And then she looked away and continued doing what she was doing. And months later, I was in college. End of story. It is important that you understand how significant it is today that you stuck through the process and you became a finisher. There are so many people in this world who have failed at accomplishing greatness simply because they gave up prematurely. Possibly take out a little bit of the highs, maybe that'll help. There are so many people in this world who have failed in accomplishing greatness simply because they gave up prematurely or ran, watch this, with the wrong crowd and dropped out of the race of their life assignment that was given to them by God. This is very important. Acclaimed author speaker Dr. Mike Murdoch has long said that the only reason men fail is broken focus. Just recently in a sermon, I took the bold liberty to add to Dr. Murdoch's statement, and I say that men also fail because of wrong focus. This brought back a very painful memory to me because I remember clearly I was in grade 8. Miss Knowles was my homeroom teacher, and she gave me an assignment. At the end of the assignment, I was always very good with words. At the end of the assignment, she called me to her desk. She looked me in the eye. She said, Devin, this was an incredible piece of work. Your writing is spectacular. Your focus on the subject is good. Then she looked at me and said, however, Devin, you wrote on the wrong topic. She said, had you written on the topic I gave you, this would have been an A. But I'm sorry, I have no choice but to give you an F. I didn't read the instructions properly. So I had focus, I finished the assignment, but I just finished the wrong assignment. I came to the conclusion that based upon this fact, it is possible to have unbroken focus on the wrong assignment, and if you get an A on the wrong assignment, it is still an F. Finishing today has officially given you a running head start on the assignment of your life called next. This is not the end. It is amazing. I just had my class reunion. Wow, time is flying. 30-year class reunion. They came to my church, and you'd be amazed. After the day, you probably won't see some of your friends for a while. And when you see them again years later, some would have moved on like you would have. But you may just be surprised that some people have chosen to kind of stay in the same place. Don't you embrace that kind of mindset. There is more to accomplish. A lot of people after high school, they celebrate high school, yay, I finished, and then they just sit in the seat of comfortability, not realizing that there's so much more to accomplish. You just accomplished all that you did in less than 20 years. Think about that for a moment. You went through all that stuff from nursery to to grade one, to grade three GLAD, to grade six GLAD, to graduating out of grade six, to getting into junior high school, to going through all GLAD again in grade eight, then your BJCs, and all of your other accomplishments. You did that in less than 20 years. Please do not sit down for the next 20 years and do nothing. There is so much more to accomplish. Can I get the parents to say amen?
Amen.
Thank you so much. Finishing today, as officially giving you a head start on the assignment called next. More than just completing high school, your finishing is of monumental historical significance because you entered high school in a pandemic, survived COVID attacks, along with all of the emotional and psychological trauma associated with it. You survived the cataclysmic adjustment of moving from the face-to-face educational experience to the awkward, at first, digital platform learning experience. And just when you had adjusted to coming to class in your uniform top and your pajama bottom, you were told to return to the classroom for face-to-face learning. I laughed at this experience because my children were like, they didn't want to do the digital experience, but they got so used to it, putting on their uniform top, their pajama button, and they're like, this is great. And then they got the call, come back to school. You went through a whole lot of adjustments, but I'm so proud of you today because you made it to the finishing line. Come on, give them a round of applause, everybody. You guys conquered a lot to be here today, and so I'll say it again, class of 2022, you guys are finishers. Ecclesiastes 9:11 declares, the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. The spoils of the battle always go to those who unapologetically endure to the end. Let's talk about our world today. We are living in a most exciting juncture of human history. Even before the pandemic, technology was moving at such record-breaking speeds that by the time you had finished making your installment payments on your iPhone, another one was either being marketed or already in stores. You just finished paying for it, and now a new one is out. Commercial airplanes, speedboats, cruise ships, as big as major inland resorts, smartphones, electric cars, Google Maps that allows you to zoom in on any part of the world in real time, real estate being sold today on Mars, and now commercial spaceships that allow for passenger travel to space thanks to Elon Musk. As a planet, we are literally manifesting ideas that our forefathers could not have even imagined. When my father grew up and when your grandparents grew up, there was no electricity, there was no running water, there was no indoor bathroom, there was no regular phone in most homes. Look how far we've come in such a short period of time. Wow, God is amazing. We are literally manifesting ideas that our forefathers could not have even imagined. The intellectual and technological accomplishments of humanity is absolutely astounding. And I need you to know that because of the incomprehensible depth of the mind of God, there is so much more for us to accomplish, and specifically for you to make happen in our world. Yes, there are more things to be discovered. There are more breakthroughs. There are more prizes to be won. Because you are finishers, class of 2022, you will not be mere onlookers at the new breakthroughs and major accomplishments to come in the world ahead of us. I have come, I'm gonna put on my spiritual hat, to prophesy and declare unto you that the capacity to be visionary participants in producing greatness lies within you. You need only to pay attention to these things, and this is how you step confidently into your dreams. You need to, one, make and keep God first in your life. Make and keep. Someone said make and keep.
Make and keep.
Make and keep God first in your life. Number two, make excellence the standard for whatever you put your mind and hands to do. I have such a problem based upon the disciplinary parents that I have. I have a problem with people who do the stuff that you give them to do any kind of how. They just want to get through it so they can go on to the next. But that's wrong. The Bible says, whatever you do, do it as unto the Lord. So if you take on an assignment, you should do it with the spirit of excellence. I used to tell the people in my church, you can tell a lot about a person by giving them a simple task of sweeping a room. Could you sweep this room for me? And you'll be amazed of how differently people take the assignment. Some people will sweep the dirt in the corners and push it under the rug. Some people will sweep one area where they think people will see, and they'll leave the rest of the areas. And then there's that person who will move all the furniture, move all the rugs, sweep properly, dust out the stuff, and properly clean the room. You can tell a lot about a person with simple assignments. Like, for example, your teachers made some early decisions about what kind of person you were based upon how you presented the homework, or did not present the homework, or blame the dog, or blame the little brother, or turned in messy work. I'm telling you today, make it your standard to do whatever you do with the spirit of excellence. So two is, make excellence the standard for whatever you put your mind and hands to do. Number three, this is very important. I got this one directly from Dr. Miles over 20 years ago. Went to visit him, and he asked me, what are you here for? I said, sir, I would like to talk to you about my vision. He said, what is your vision? And I started to talk. I mean, I used my best language. I was confident. I was poised. And he stopped in the middle and said, you don't have a vision. I said, excuse me? He said, you don't have a vision. I thought the man was insulting the greatness within me. And so I looked at him, I said, what do you mean? He says, you're telling me these thoughts out of your head. He said, do you have it written down? I said, no, sir, but I know it. He said, no, you don't have a vision. You do not have a vision until you write it down. Right? Write your vision down and keep it accessible. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2 says, write it down on tablets and make it plain so that others who read it can run with it. If you get an opportunity, you know, this world is so small today, and our country is so favored. There are billionaires walking in this country today in certain places. Go and visit Ocean Club. Go and visit Albany. Go and visit Life Key. You'd be amazed at who lives there. Watch this. Suppose you have this great idea that you want to accomplish, and you run into one of these people. One of my friends just ran into the guy who owns FTX. One of the world's youngest and newest billionaires, who lives where? Right here in the Bahamas. What if you run into this guy? And he says, what do you want to do? And he says, could you show it and present it to me? And you're like, and you're stammering because you've never took the time to write your plan out, to calculate the budget, and to say how much you need. You're standing before somebody who can make it happen today, but you don't have it. So this is very important. The adults should have been blessed with that too. Write out your vision. Make it accessible. Make it plain so that you never know when you might run into the person who can make it financially happen. And number four, choose the right association. Choose the right company. This is huge. Proverbs 13 verse 20 says, he that will be wise must associate with other wise men, because a companion of fools will be destroyed. Who's a fool? The Bible's not being insulted. The Bible clearly defines who a fool is. Whoever says that there is no God, the Bible calls that individual a fool. Now let me say this very clearly. It did not say, if you don't call me Jehovah God, you're a fool. He says, if you don't believe that there's a source and a creator of this planet and a creator of your life, you've got to be crazy. There are too many details. There is a God. Hallelujah. Choose the right association. Why? Because the scripture says in 1 Corinthians 15:33 that bad company corrupts good morals. Now, as a pastor, I've had to counsel many parents who came into my office crying, Pastor, I don't know what my child is doing. They're smoking, they're drinking, they're doing this craziness. And I thought I raised them right. I brought them to church. I taught them the Bible. I gave them these principles. I sent them to school. I paid for their education. What did I do wrong? Sometimes the answer, parents, is nothing. You did nothing wrong. If your children hang with the wrong crowd, bad company corrupts good morals. So I'm telling you, regardless of how smart you think you are, make sure you choose the right crowd to run with. I learned this many years ago. I couldn't believe it. Fortune 500 companies in America, they said that before they hire you for a big job, they usually ask you or try to find out who your closest five friends are. Because it is said that if I can find the five closest people in your inner circle, I can tell you everything about yourself. Because you usually hang with the people who make the same kind of money you make. You usually hang with the same people who go to the same social spots and social things that you like to do. So I can discover the kind of person you are by looking at your five closest friends. Choose wisely. Our world needs you. Notwithstanding the aforestated greatness of today's world, when it comes to knowledge and innovation, there is a great void in our present world that cannot be fixed by a new computer, cell phone, or a new jet. This problem that I speak of is that of moral character and integral fortitude. This is huge. Moral character and integral fortitude. Our world today seems to embrace the idea of moral relativism and situational ethics. Many world leaders seem to be on a mission of, watch this, making God irrelevant. Keep your eyes on our leaders of today. Making God irrelevant and his laws nothing more than a fairy tale. I tell you today, this is more than blasphemous. It is a recipe for complete failure, and I dare say to you, annihilation of humanity as we know it. If God is the creator, and if he is the source of all things, and if we move, and we breathe, and we have our being, if it is him who told the waters how far to go, if it is him that has created every living creature, how dare we continue in his world and make him irrelevant? Makes no sense whatsoever. If you want to know the purpose of life, Dr. Munro would say, you must read the manuscript. And the manuscript for this life, according to what I believe, is the Word of God. We only exist because of God. I'm getting ready to close. And that's not a preacher close, that's a real close. We only exist because of God. The earth remains because, class of 2022, God is holy and true to his word. What does that mean? Wow. We don't know how many thousands, some people say thousands, some people say billions of years ago. We don't know how long it was that God says, let there be light. And from he said it because he's holy and because he's true to whatever he says, the sun comes up every day, moon comes up every night, and they function for thousands to millions to billions of years just as God commanded it because he is holy. The waters do not consume the earth because God told it not to go past this boundary line. Glory to God. We don't experience world flooding that kills everybody no more because God says, I won't do it no more. What is very interesting, I'm just going to throw this in there. What is very interesting, he made a promise to us, and with the promise, he put a rainbow in the sky. A rainbow with the intention of saying to us, I will not flood this world again, but when I'm finished with this dispensation, there will be fire that consumes it and purifies it. It is amazing to me that how some people think that you should celebrate the rainbow for anything else but what God has declared. I'm going to leave that right there. We only exist because of God. The earth remains because he is holy and true. God is integral and demands the same of his creation. In the days ahead, I believe God will be raising up so many more islanders. People from the islands. Why do you say that? I say that because there's a scripture in Psalms that says, out of the isles of the sea, there will come forth perfected praise. The people who once came to us to bring us inventions and bring us the Bible, as they said, and even though they shortly after enslaved us, the people from these nations have now seemed to have lost their sense of moral balance. And I believe that scripture in Psalms that says, out of the isles of the sea, there shall come forth perfected praise, means that God is about to raise us up in the last days and send us forth to minister, to teach, to bring forth technologies and ideas to them. And it's already happening. I believe God will be raising up so many more islanders like a Dr. Miles Munro to travel the world and to remind humanity that we are still the creation of God, and as such ought to acknowledge him and give him glory for whatever he has blessed us to accomplished. Clap it right into you. As you get your awards, as you get your certificate, as you make your plans, either to go to university or to go into the workplace, whatever you do, I want to remind you of this fact. It's important to stay humble. As a pastor, I have the privilege of counseling and seeing the lives of people from the time they are born straight until the time they pass out of this earth. And one of the most egregious things to see is to see a child who a parent has invested everything in, that child go on to success and then become so arrogant that they despise the very people who made it possible for them to be great. Stay humble and always look back to be a blessing to the people who pour into your life so that you can become great. That's your parents, that's your guardians, that's also your teachers. Always remember to look back every now and again to be a blessing to the people who made it possible for you to accomplish greatness. It has been my privilege and honor today to share a few words of encouragement to you so that you will dare to dream, be bold enough to pursue that dream with confidence and excellence. I know today you've accomplished greatness already in finishing this assignment. It's only the beginning. Take a moment to celebrate. Take a moment to give God praise and set your feet on a solid ground and get ready to accomplish more. I greet the song, You Will Win. God bless you. Thank you so much.
I want to thank everyone for being here with us today.